اشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد وانتشت روحي وصار الدمع يجري يا إلهي خذ بقلبي للرشاد
أشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين. الصلاة والسلام على من كان نبيا والآدم بين الماء والتين. الحمد لله. All praise are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him and we glorify Him and we send darud and salam upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is always a pleasure, you know, coming here to Barakpur. MashaAllah, such people with wonderful hearts. Alhamdulillah. You know, coming to the masjid, it reminds me of Makkah, right? The outskirts of Makkah. Those who have stayed in the outskirts of Makkah, you know, in every village, when the adhan is called, you hear the adhan on different loudspeakers, different adhan. So mashallah, you know, it creates an awareness of as well. Right? It creates an awareness of salat. It is the time for salat. And mashallah, you know, passing holy masajids, you could see there are cars in the masjid, in the car parks. There are people that is going for salat, which is indeed, you know, something beneficial for the community and, you know, for the entire ummah that we fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is very important. And within our lives as well, you know, we should always try our best and fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us as well about salat. Allah says, wa'amur ahlaka bis salat. Command your family, Allahu Akbar. Command your family of with salat, Allahu Akbar. So as much as mashallah, we as brothers, we are in the masjid, you know, that worried and that fikr and that, you could say, that worry within for the female folks and the sisters at home, it should always be there within our, in our hearts. You know what, I want as well that my family establish salat. Right? Because many a times, us as brothers, we are in the masjid, but our wives at home, they are not establishing the salat. And similarly as well, the fikr, right, and the following of the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, each and every command of Allah, especially what is upon us that of Ramadan and fasting in the month of Ramadan, you know, this awareness of Ramadan, right, sometimes is not created fully. There are some people who still doesn't understand what is Ramadan. There are some people who still consider fasting in the month of Ramadan as something insignificant. There are some people still that they do not fast and they make petty different type of excuses. You know, I have to go put a spin today, I can't fast. Within our Jamaat as well. I have to go put a spin, I can't fast today. Or you know what, I have to go by the doctor. Or you know what, I have to go by the embassy, I can't fast. No. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us as well. He says, Yuridu Allah bikum al-yusr wa la yuridu bikum al-usr. Allah reminds us as well that Allah intends easiness for us and Allah doesn't intend to make it difficult for us. So Ramadan and creating an awareness of Ramadan, of what Ramadan is actually about, is the responsibility of all of us. Is the responsibility of all of us to create that awareness within our homes and our family. You have a brother not fasting. Don't fast, mashallah. And if you want to fast, no. Muslims are not like this. Muslims are not selfish people that got worried as well for our parents or our brothers or sisters or family. And I'm sure we have family. Some families still struggle. Some of our family members still struggling with salat. Some of our family members still struggling with deen. Some of our family members, you know, still struggling to understand Islam. MashaAllah, we are in the masjid. We are approaching Ramadan. We are about to have, you know, feel this, MashaAllah, this witness this blessed month. So too, that awareness and wanting our families and neighbors as well, it should be within us. Because this is what, this is from among the lessons of Ramadan as well. Sharing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us, you know that famous ayah of Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, O you who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, He tells us, Nuku anfusakum wa ahlikum nara wa quduha an-nasu wal hijara. O you who believe, safeguard yourself, Allah wa ahlikum and your family, nara wa quduha an-nasu wal hijara, from such a fire whose flame is man and stone. Allahu Akbar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't say, oh, you believe, save yourself, you know, from a fire. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, save yourself and your family. And yet the ulama, they makes a deduction, they gives an explanation. They said that this word ahlikum, it refers to your direct family, right? It with your family tree, as well, it includes as well the area that you're from, your geographic location. Subhanallah. So this is a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And many commands of Allah in Quran come like this as well. You know, we know people. You know, we haven't seen them in the masjid since Ramadan. Or maybe last two Ramadan. So as we love Ramadan and, you know, we want to witness Ramadan, you know, that worried and that fikr of Ramadan and it, that these people fast as well, we should have it. This is just a reminder for myself and for all of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds as well. He says, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And remind, very reminder is beneficial for the believers. When people see Ramadan today, or when people hear about Ramadan, we see Ramadan as generally, you know, just a general overview of Ramadan. A lot of people see Ramadan as, you know, a month of fasting, staying away from eating, staying away from drinking. But my brothers and sisters, Ramadan is more than this. This is how we see Ramadan. But Ramadan is more than this. Ramadan is just more than, you know, coming to the masjid, mashallah, establishing our Taraweeh Salat and having a nice meal. It is more than this. It is plenty, plenty more than this. Ramadan, you know what we are not seeing and what we should know, Ramadan is what? A month of what? Discipline. It is a month of self-discipline. It is teaching us to stay away from that which is halal. Allahu Akbar. Everything in our kitchen halal. But guess what? On the days of Ramadan, it becomes haram. So Ramadan teaches us discipline. It teaches us to stay away from that which is halal. And if we can stay away from that which is halal for 1 month, then it will be easy for us to stay away from that which is haram for the entire year. Allahu Akbar. So Ramadan, it teaches us discipline. It teaches us as well good eating habits. And this is objective, and this is what we should achieve from Ramadan as well. It's training the nafs. It's about self-restraint. Well, for me and for most of us, that is what it should be. That we restrain from the for the entire month. And when I say restrain, you know, some people, mashallah, they restrain during the day. But guess what? In the evening, they make up for what they miss. They make up, no, still have one third. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, it is sufficient for you to eat a morsel or two and keep your back strong. The Prophet Hassan, he says that the worst vessel that the children of Adam can fill is their stomach. Subhanallah. So it is discipline, it is restrain, it is full of spiritual and physical benefits as well. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he reminds us in one narration in Sahih al-Bukhari, he says, "Ni'matani mabgunun fihi ma kathirun min al-nas." That there are two favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala people frequently neglect: as-siha wal-farag. Siha, good health, and free time. Subhanallah, today is not even something wrong. With our health, then is when we become health conscious. Ramadan teaches us, Ramadan is teaching us that how we should, you know, live, how we should eat for the entire year as well, the kind of restraint that we should have. It teaches us, you know, good eating habits to take care of our health. That is why, you know, old people would say, make food your medicine before medicine become your food. Have you ever heard that? It's true. It's really, really true. So the Prophet ﷺ in this hadith, you know, he speaks about this, about our health that we neglect. I'm asking you a question. After Ramadan, how you feel? You feel light. You feel good. You know, you feel as though you have really taken a rest from eating and overeating. Why? Because this is something, subhanAllah, that we achieve from Ramadan. So it is without a doubt self-discipline. We have to see Ramadan as like this as well. So you know what? I want to use this Ramadan. This entire month is what? A month of what? Spiritual and physical training. SubhanAllah. How much of us see Ramadan as this? It's a month of physical and spiritual training as well. SubhanAllah. That is why the ulama would say, live every day as you live in Ramadan, and the day you die would be like the day of Eid. Allahu Akbar. It is, subhanAllah, you know, a month of spiritual training. That upliftment that we gain, it should remain. It shouldn't go away. Unfortunately, my brothers and sisters, the problem with us today is that Ramadan come and Ramadan go. And our deen still remain the same. It is still at the same level. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, she would say, "Hasibu anfusakum qabla an tuhasabu." Take accountability of yourself before accountability is taken from you. Allahu Akbar. From Ramadan, from last Ramadan to this Ramadan, I always ask this question: who have added one ayah to the collection of surahs? Or who have added a surah, one surah alone, 5 ayahs or 6 ayahs? Who have added this to the collection of surahs? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said when he would walk through Medina, he would hear what? The narration mentioned, Dawiya Sauti, the humming of the voices like bees would become emanated from the houses of the Sahaba. They would establish their Nawafil Salat and they would recite their Quran. You know, gauge ourselves. Ramadan should be much more than how we see it. It should be a yardstick, it should be a mizaj that we measure our deen as well. Last Ramadan I had this quality. Alhamdulillah, this Ramadan it have gone. Inshallah, this Ramadan I want to try out a next bad quality. I want to bring a new next quality. I want to practice something of deen that I have not been practicing. Look at our life, all of us. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, all the children of Adam are sinners, and the best of sinners are those who repent. None of us is free from sins. But Ramadan is there. It's a month of spiritual cleaning, spiritual training. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says what? وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْإِدَّةَ. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْإِدَّةَ. That word comes in Quran, that you complete that period, the 1 month, or the 29 days. Allahu Akbar. وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. And when you have complete, Allahu Akbar, you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You pronounce the greatness of Allah for that which He has guided you to do. Allahu Akbar. Because His ability to fast for this month, it is only from Allah. How much people want to fast and they can't fast? Fast now before you can't fast. Ask the people who have reached old age and they want to fast. But guess what? By the time 11 o'clock, the sugar level dropped right down. They ate something. So as you can fast, fast and enjoy your fast. Fall in love with it. People fast today and they don't get anything from fasting. You know why? By 10 o'clock, you hear all kind of cries and complaints. Oh God, my belly burning me. I can't do this now, but while you're doing it. No. We should be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the ability to fast. So don't see Ramadan as some people see Ramadan as a punishment. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, there are people who see Ramadan like this. We should be happy to fight Ramadan. We should be happy to be alive in Ramadan. Let's remind me of the story of this Sahaba who came and accepted Shahada. And one of them died right after the Shaheed. And one of them lived another year. SubhanAllah. And then Sahaba got a dream. You know that this one who lived a year after, SubhanAllah, he died and he was admitted into Jannah before the Shaheed. And the Sahaba came to the Prophet with this story, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, having that one who lived 1 year after witness Ramadan, Allahu Akbar, haven't he done more righteous actions? So this is an opportunity. We don't know if we will live next Ramadan. In fact, we don't know if I will this Ramadan. But Alhamdulillah, if we are, mashallah, we are approaching Ramadan and we have that health and strength, and inshallah, we witness Ramadan. Make the best of Ramadan. Make the best of Ramadan. So it is without a doubt a month of spiritual training. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, as well in the ayah, the end, he says, well, allakum tashkurun, perhaps you may be what? But thankful and grateful to Allah for this as well. That is why the day of Eid, you know, we say Alhamdulillah. We should feel good that, you know what, I have done this. I have lived another year of Ramadan. You know, I have fasted, I have completed all of my fast. We should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he reminds us as well. He says, إِذَا سَرَّتْكَ حَسْنَتُكَ وَسَاءَتْكَ سَيَّتُكَ فَأَنْتَ مُؤْمِنٌ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that if your good deeds make you happy, if your good deeds make you happy and your bad deeds make you sad, فَأَنْتَ مُؤْمِنٌ, then you are a true believer. Allahu Akbar. Even you just pray a Maghrib Salat, you feel good about it. And if you had missed Maghrib Salat, you know that's on your mind, oh God, I missed Maghrib today. It makes us sad. Then subhanAllah, that is a quality of Iman. It means that Iman is in your heart. Anytime you miss a compulsion, or you have done something wrong and you regret it, that's a sign of Iman. That's a sign of what? Of tawfiq to do righteous action from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this month of Ramadan that is approaching, you know, as believers, you know, mashallah, you know, it's in the air. We should anticipate Ramadan as well. You know, knowing that Ramadan is coming, we should be anticipating. You know, we should be speaking about it. We should be making preparation, subhanallah, for Ramadan. And the preparation for Ramadan? Spiritual preparation. Yes, mashallah, physical preparation. You ask someone, you prepare for Ramadan, and they reply, yes, I don't wipe up the house. Wash up, mashallah, very good. But spiritual preparation as well, and that is, you know, we start fasting this month of Sha'ban. Now I feel fast in preparation of Ramadan. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, and she would say that I never see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, fast so much as he would fast in the month of Sha'ban. And then she said, "Summa yasiluhu Ramadan." This line, you know, "Summa yasiluhu Ramadan." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would connect it to Ramadan. He would fast, and then he would connect the fast to Ramadan. That's what we should do as well, right? To gain the full benefit of Ramadan. If we don't fast in Sha'ban, if we don't start reading Quran, and we don't start establishing Nawafil Salat, when the month of Ramadan comes, the first 2 days of Ramadan comes, mind you, me, it will go. It will be wasted. You know why? Because the first day of Ramadan, you're not in the mood of Ramadan. Your body have not been accustomed to fasting. So the first week of Ramadan, you will take to get accustomed to fasting. You will take to get accustomed to making long du'as and tarawih salat. By the time you get accustomed to Ramadan, it's the last 10 days of Ramadan. But if that preparation is made now, and you know, we put, you know, everything in order, like for example, those people who have jobs. People take jobs for what? Christmas holiday. People take holidays for Christmas holiday. As a believer, as a Muslim, we should be taking holiday for Ramadan. We should be applying for time off for at least 2 weeks of Ramadan or 3 weeks or the entire month. You know, people who have jobs and they never take time off. No. This is the special time of the year. This is the time that we want the reward, we want the blessings. You know, we want the more time on our hands to do ibadat. The more time, subhanAllah, you know their famous statement, time is money. No, time is blessings right now. Right, for the month of Ramadan, time is blessing, because the more time you have is the more ibadat you can do, subhanAllah. The more time that you can spend in the masjid. So the month of Ramadan, you know, is dawning upon us. Tonight being, subhanAllah, the 50th night of Sha'ban. A beautiful narration. There's so much, mashallah, you have heard. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked down at his creation on his 50th night of Sha'ban, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives his entire creation, except what? Illa al-mushrik. Except someone who associates partners with Allah. Or mushahin, someone who holds malice in his heart for other people, right? As a spiritual ailment, right? So except someone who commits shirk, and join partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, that is why, you know, there are so much du'as that we should make. You know, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min an ushrika bika shay. Oh Allah, I seek your protection, ya Allah, I seek your forgiveness if I have ever associated any partners with you. SubhanAllah, sometimes we infringe on the lordship quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without even knowing it. Again, sometimes we infringe on the lordship qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without even knowing it. Like, simple. Someone is sick. The moment somebody should get a headache, we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's a Shafi. Allah is the curer. We should first make dua. But, you know, someone is sick, the first trust is on the tablet. Right, the first trust is on the Panadol, which should not be. Right, and if we are taking these type of cure, Bismillah as well. We say Bismillah in the name of Allah. And if Allah wills, it will work. If Allah doesn't will, it will not work. The second part mentioned Mushahin, you know, someone who have malice in their heart. SubhanAllah. My brothers and sisters, you know, such a night. You know, this reminds me of the incident or the story of the Sahaba with a man of Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sitting his companions and he asked them, would you like to see a man of Jannah? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, look, this man is going to enter his garden. And the man entered the garden. And Sahaba is looking, wow, this is a man of Jannah. What is it so special? The second day, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him the same question. Would you like to see a man from among the people of Jannah? SubhanAllah. On the third day, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked the same question. Would you like to see a man from among the people of Jannah? And the Sahaba said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, look, this man will now enter the garden. And that man walked into the garden. And he left, and the Sahaba, they were amazed. What is it this man is doing? What is it this man is doing? That he's been known right now, he's been guaranteed Jannah. So one Sahaba became inquisitive and he went to the house of the man and he knocks on the door and he says, "I'm a traveler." And the man hosted him for 3 days. And the Sahaba says, "Yes, I'll now find out. What is so special about this man that he's been guaranteed Jannah?" And he looks at him in a night. He realized this man didn't spend a whole night in tahajjud. And he didn't fast the day either. So the Sahaba said, "Perhaps he's unwell, he's sick." And Sahaba says, "You know, tomorrow we'll see what he's doing different." Same thing. The man went to bed early. His companion went to bed early. Didn't fast the next day. Third night, same thing. The man slept whole night. His companion slept whole night. Didn't fast the next day. The third day, the Sahaba leaves. And he's leaving. And this man, he asked the companion, were you here to find out something? He says, "Yes, I have a question." What? And he related to him that incident that a man says, "You know what? We heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that you are from among the people of Jannah. I wanted to see what you are doing differently." And the man said to the Sahaba, "You can look at me, I'm just a normal person." He says, "But there is one thing I do every night. What is it?" And the man replied, "Every night before I sleep, I forgive everyone." Allahu Akbar. "Before I sleep, I forgive people." Subhanallah. "Before I sleep, I clear my heart and my mind from people." Allahu Akbar. Just imagine, look at the simple quality that this man possessed that has made him guarantee Jannah to enter the Jannah of Allah. Simple quality. Subhanallah. It's in connection with the narration. You know, people who have hatred and malice, you know, sometimes we enter Ramadan and we enter Ramadan with this type of mind as well. "I'm not talking to this one, I'm not talking to that one. I don't want to see this one, I don't want to see that one." If Allah can forgive people, then who are we to forgive them? That is why, you know, this hadith, this famous hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, you know, "At-tuhuru shatrul iman," that cleanliness is half of faith. Cleanliness of our bodies and our place and stuff like that should be clean. Imam Ghazali alayhi rahmah, he went on further to explain this hadith. And he said that this hadith refers to the mind and the heart as well. Subhanallah. To the mind and the heart as well. Cleanliness is half of faith. Our mind should be clear, our mind should be clean, our perception of people should be clean as well, our heart. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ijtanibu katheeran min adh-dhann." Subhanallah. You know, we enter into the month of Ramadan. We want to enter clean and we want to come out clean as well. Because this is the month, you know, shaitan's gonna use chain, but subhanallah, the effects is still there. So we want to live and we want to enjoy, you know, a peaceful Ramadan. What is gonna happen, you know, when we have peace before Ramadan as well? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "O you who believe, stay away from a lot of suspicion." Subhanallah. You're always thinking, everybody thinking. People always have perception about people. "I think she is this, you know, or she is that, you know. Or this brother, I always see him on the same jubba. Like, why don't press his jubba? She don't wash it." You know, sometimes we have these thoughts and they will come, but we have to kill them. When these thoughts come in our minds, we have to say, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim." Because that's not the thinking of a believer. I always say, sometimes, you know, you see behind, you're driving and you see behind those cars a statement, "Bad mind don't prosper." And you all ever see that? It's true. Because people who have negativity with them, you know, that's a means of what? Keeping them down. They will not be initiative. They will not prosper. They will remain right there with their negativity. And that's not the attitude and the behavior of a Muslim. So the Ramadan is coming, you know, to enjoy this month of Ramadan. These are, you know, qualities that we should work on and we should build on before Ramadan. And we should what have istiqamah on them as well. Because, you know, Ramadan is not a month that you put a pause on all bad habits. And when Ramadan finish, you press play. People like that today. Ramadan, they have become angels. And after Ramadan, a'udhu billah, the shaitan jump all back. So, you know, Ramadan is, subhanAllah, is more than what we see Ramadan of being. Right? Then we are just seeing the surface of Ramadan, but, you know, look deep below those little qualities and, you know, that Ramadan is teaching us. We should be aware of them as well. We want to gain as much as possible from this month of Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke about fasting as well, and he says, "Rubba sa'imin laysa lahu min siyami illa ju." Famous hadith. How many people fast but gain nothing from fasting except hunger? Subhanallah. And how many people stand at night and gain nothing from standing except tiredness? Why? Because, you know, they fast during the month of Ramadan, but while they fasting, subhanallah, that tongue, they cannot control that tongue. And some people, you know, subhanallah, they feel what? If they don't talk about people, they don't feel good. There are some people when they backbite, you know, it's as though they feel some type of ecstasy. They feel good. There are some people, they cannot start a conversation except by talking about people. They come, hey, you hear what happened? You hear the good news? Or you hear what's going on with this fella? My brothers and sisters, shun these people. You're not in need of people like this within your life. And the moment you show them the correct path and you correct them, mashallah, is either you have lost them or they remain. So the month of Ramadan, you know, subhanallah, we want to... This Ramadan that comes, you know, we want a smooth flow into Ramadan. And we want as well continuity and istiqamah. Month of Ramadan starts, everybody, mashallah, they have a hot Pepsi effect. You know, you throw hot Pepsi in a glass, and it just, and sometimes it flow over, and then it just boil on back to nothing. Right? Sometimes we start so speed, when in the middle of Ramadan, we boil down. And then we try to boil up back, we try to go up back. And the end of Ramadan, and then Ramadan goes away. You know, throughout Ramadan, from now on Ramadan, and after Ramadan, we should be that same individual. The level of our taqwa should be there. The level of our tawakkul should be there. Ramadan should make us such people, better people after Ramadan. And Ramadan to Ramadan, we should inculcate good qualities in our lives that we become, you know, the best of ourselves. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, he's saying how much people fast but gain nothing. So who don't speak, they listen. Some initiate, but controlling the tongue, my brothers and sisters, is a must in Ramadan and out of Ramadan as well. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, whoever guarantee me the protection of that which is between his leg and his jaws, I will guarantee him Jannah. Allahu Akbar. This affects us as believers, as well as it affects our fast during the month of Ramadan. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, وَرُبَّ قَائِمْ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ كِيَامِهِ لَسَّهَمْ. That how much people stand for salat at night but gain nothing but tiredness. Why? Because we stand, and some subhanallah, sometimes people stand for tarawih salat, and the only thing that they have in their mind when they have is good honoring. When they have is finished, why are you taking so long? Subhanallah, and then they leave and they go. We should want to enjoy Quran. Because what? Ramadan is the month of Quran. It is without a doubt the month of Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Shahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. The month of Ramadan which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran. So within our ta'ala we salat. You know, we want to enjoy our Quran. We want to listen to Quran. That is all it takes of us. When the imam is in front, what do we have to do? When the imam is leading salat, our intention is that I intend to follow the imam. Subhanallah, we have to do nothing except to listen to the Quran and clearing our minds from all different thoughts and stuff like that that keep on coming. All we have to do is listen to the Quran, and that is subhanallah that we have our salat. And you know, we should want to listen to the Quran, because the Quran is what? It's a book of guidance, and there are so much of benefits from the Quran. Hidayat and shifa, you name it, subhanallah, everything we get from Quran. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ شَيْءٌ يَتَبَاءَهُونَ بِهِ. For every ummah, there is something that, you know, they boast about. Allahu Akbar. For every ummah, there is something that they boast about. فَإِنَّ بَهَا أُمَّةِ الْقُرْآنِ. For verily that thing that my ummah will boast about is the Quran. Do we boast about Quran? Have we asked our friends who are not Muslims, have you ever read the Quran? Have we ever played some Quran for them to listen? Have we ever sent them a nice recitation of Quran? Do we boast about this Quran that we have been given? Do we see the effect of the Quran in our lives? Many people today, my brothers and sisters, many houses, you know where the Quran is right now? On the shelf. You know when it will come off the shelf? Ramadan month. You know when it will go back on the shelf? After Ramadan. It's a known fact that subhanAllah that we have to change. That connection should be there with Quran. Every single day we should be reading a portion of Quran. Every single day of our lives. The closest and the connection we keep with our phone, the Quran should be closer to us than this. The Quran should be closer to us than this. Why? It's a book of guidance for us. Allah tells us this. Hudan lin nas, a means of guidance. And that's why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam teaches that the virtues of reading Surah Yasin on a daily basis, on the different ayahs and Surah of Al-Quran. Because we are in need of Quran. We are in need of Quran. This reminds me, you know, of the story of one Sahaba, Usayd bin Hudayr. You know, he's in the porch and he's reading Quran. And I guess you all heard this story already, and his horse started to prance. And he goes outside. And he looks up and he realized, you know, in fact, he started to realize that every time he would come to stop, the horse would pause. But then as soon as he continued reading, the horse would start to prance again. It's narration in Sahih Muslim. And he goes outside and he looks up and he sees, you know, something like a lamp descending. Subhanallah. And when he stopped, it disappeared. And the next day he goes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he says, the Messenger of Allah, last night I witnessed something. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, oh Usayd, that was the angel descending to listen to your recitation of Quran. Had you continued to read till Fajr, it would have remained there and people would have seen it. Subhanallah. That's the effect of our Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us as well in Quran, he says, Inna Quran al-Fajr kana mashhura. That the Quran that is recited at Fajr time is what? Witnessed by angels. Angel descend to listen to this recitation. But guess what? Many of us home that time. If we had broken our sleep for the pleasure of Allah, subhanAllah, we receive all goodness in life. I always say, if our purpose If we have prayed Fajr Salat in the masjid, then we have found our purpose in life. It is important that we be here in the masjid every single day of our lives. So that Quran, subhanAllah, the ayah, you know, that the Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan. The Quran, the Mufassirin mentioned that this Quran was revealed from, the entire Quran was revealed from Baitul Izzah ila Sama'id Dunya in Ramadan. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received the first revelation in the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah. And the angel Jibreel will come and rehearse the Quran with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam during the month of Ramadan. That is why, subhanAllah, that miracle that we have home on the shelves, take it up, read it. It is without, inside of it is full of so much of guidance, and understand the Quran as well. This is something that we have been granted to this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the month of Ramadan is special of what? Because of the Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan. We have been given Laylatul Qadr in the month of Ramadan. And so too under the tafsir of this ayah, the month of Ramadan where the Quran was revealed under the tafsir, Allama Ibn Kathir, he mentions that every single revealed book was revealed in Ramadan. The Tawrat, the Zabur, and the Injil, and the scroll that was given to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, all of these was as well revealed in the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah. Now why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he consoles this ummah as well when he says, O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you. Allahu Akbar. Allah could have just said, O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed for you. Perhaps you may attain taqwa. But to console this ummah, Allah is letting us know that not you alone fasting, or not you alone, this command of fasting was given to the ummahs and the nation before you, they fasted as well. Allahu Akbar. Consoling this ummah. That when we fast, we will receive such bounties. And that is why the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, As-siyamu li wa ana ajzibi. How much, who knows the amount of reward you will gain for fasting a day of Ramadan? Nobody knows. Right, you know, for different ibadahs, you know, the reward is known. You pray in Masjid al-Nabawi, you get 10,000 blessings. You pray in Makkah and Haram, you get what? 100,000 blessings for Salat. You give a dollar, it multiplies 700 times. You make Umrah in Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's like Hajj with me. You pray Salatul Duha, or Ishraq and Hajj, the word is known. You give Zakah, the reward is known, there is benefits, but for fasting it's different. It's a whole different ball game. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, As-siyamu li wa ana ajzibi. That fasting is for me, and I will personally give the reward of fasting. Allahu Akbar. So that the fast that we fast, that reward is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That hunger that we are during Ramadan, Allah's gonna reward us for this. And we're gonna see this on the day of judgment. La yughadiru saghiratan wala kabiratan illa ahsaha. Nothing is excluded from the book. On the day of judgment, people would say, Ma li hadha al-kitab? What is wrong with this book? What is wrong with this book? There's so much of blessings that have been recorded. I haven't done all of this. Where has it come from? Allahu Akbar. SubhanAllah, it's these actions that we do. And we don't do it alone, but we do it with love. You fast in the month of Ramadan? Yes, mashallah, you gain taqwa, it's a command of Allah. But fast because you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fast because you want to build your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fast because you want to get this height of spirituality. Fast because you want the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this was the criteria of the Sahaba. The Quran mentions, وَرِضْوَانُ مِنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. We gain many things in life, but my brothers and sisters, the pleasure of Allah is the greatest achievement. We can achieve nothing better than the pleasure of Allah at all costs. That is why we seek the pleasure of Allah and the displeasure of His creation. Always, we live by this principle. Our time for salat, we establish our salat. Our Ramadan, nothing holds us back. Our fasting, nothing holds us back. Because these were the etiquettes. And these were the commands, subhanAllah. And these were the sunnah that was left with us by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the morals and the values that was taught to us by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we will establish. And subhanAllah, that is why this ummah is known as an ummah of morals and values. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left this dunya ages ago. But the command of Allah and the sunnah and the values that Islam has taught us, we stick to them until today. That's why we hold on to our Islam. And that is why Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, he would say, Nahnu qawmun a'izzan Allahu bil Islam. That we are a people who Allah has given izzah by giving us Islam. لَوْ تَغَيْنَ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا أَذَلَّنَ اللَّهِ. If you were to seek other than Islam as a way of life, أَذَلَّنَ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will what? Disgrace us. It's Ramadan, my brothers and sisters. You know, there are so much hadith and proves what? Similarly, this night and this month of Shaban, there are so much of hadith, you know, it shows and it tells us and it proves to us the value and the great virtues that we don't want to miss it. At all costs, we don't want to miss anything. We want to live it, we want to feel it, we want to reap the reward. And that is why the scholars would say what? Rajab is a month of what? Sowing. And Shaban is a month of what? Cultivating. Now we prepare. We make good use. And Ramadan is what? It's a reaping. When Ramadan comes, all we want to do, inshallah, is to reap. We want the full benefits, maximum reward, nothing short. Everything should be in our favor, walking smooth. We want to make such preparations so that we will enjoy this Ramadan like that, inshallah. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He bless us. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He grant us the understanding of these few words and the hadith. Wa la fi rida wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum.